photographs don't always have to be taken at face value. In the Ivory Coast, one artist's oversaturated work is making a colourful statement.
My universe is a vision and at the same time a wish. I would love to contribute to this world constructive stories that make people grow and make them grow in a happy way.
My name is Paul Sika, an Imagineer, and this is my Africa.
Imagineer is a person that fuses imagination and engineering. It's about having the most profound, the deepest visions, and using as much technology as we can in order to make this vision a reality here and now. My vision is about something that looks like sci-fi or looks like a fantastic world.
Paul Sika's vision is simply out of this world. His degree in software engineering, combined with his artistic imagination, is pushing boundaries.
When I saw a trailer of The Matrix once, I was positively flabbergasted.
What is The Matrix?
It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
As soon as I saw the trailer, I said, I want to make films. I want to create that kind of stories. And that's where it crystallized. I experimented. I got some books on filmmaking. And I studied whatever I could find and started to experiment as much as I could. And that's where I theorized my style of photography, which I call photomaking, from the two influences, photography and filmmaking. Beautiful day. Welcome. This is City of Paris Gallery and my work on the side here.
His photographs are vibrant and bold, and each tells a story.
My creativity went deeper and deeper, and that's where the story started to unveil. I say unveil because I don't feel like I create. I don't think that an artist actually creates. I think it's more like you receive, and then you transmit. Yelan in Bambara, a language that we find in West Africa, means light. And even for the medium of, for the support, we have light, which was basically an awesome wedding between concept in the story and medium used to show the work. Yelanists are special people. These unique people who strive to attain that which is the most beautiful in the world. And this is their aspiration, this is what they invest their lives in, and this is where they get the harmony. I'm creating a saga, a story that goes over several generations. I've had the chance to grow up with the products of great storytellers, whether they were in the form of video games, manga, comic books, movies, animations. And these have impacted me. Video games, part of my life, childhood, and also adulthood. Look at the graphics, having those interactive pictures stuck on your eyes. This is where I've learned a lot of my color theory. That was my university. That's where I learned my art. A great video game can be played years and years and years. And a good piece of art is like this. I have learned from all corners of the world, production from everywhere. Whether it is from Japan, from the United States, from Ivory Coast, everywhere. I feed on the world, and I'll give you back to it.
Paul was born and raised in Abidjan, a place that helps shape his rich imagination.
Something that Abidjan has done for me that no other place would have been able to do in the same way is by providing me its environment. Why? Because in the environment, I see objects. And objects in photography, in images, are the building blocks of sentences. And because the environment is unique, I've been able to tell my stories in a very unique way.
His collection of widely acclaimed photographs, combined with personal anecdotes, became a book called At the Heart of Me.
Even though I knew people were gonna like it, I mean, it was still a surprise to see how far it was going. From Abidjan to Atlanta to Mountain View, Google to South Africa to France. I mean, you hope it's going to work, But I have to say that I didn't know how much it was going to work. So thankfully, it was indeed a success.
Now he's taking his success in storytelling one step further. Paul's newest project under development is a gaming app. He's partnered with an illustrator to make his vision come to life.
Here we are at play. This is the playground that we had when we were kids. We just recreated it. You know, we spent a lot of time here. Basically, all around here are sketches, keywords that are intrinsically related to our world. We're using a lot of illustrations because this is one of the best ways to actually materialize this imagination we have. In this world, humans are no longer the dominant species. The world has known a biological transformation. And an amazing amount of species actually exist now. And all of these species have the origins, have the quests, have the countries, the cities. And one thing that ties them up is the one basic and universal to this world principle of attaining that which is the most beautiful in the world.
Tu sais cette image en fait, elle est cool.
We have a ping pong, and that ping pong is going to develop more and more of the ideas until we get to a certain level that we think is harmonious. And when we get to that level, we know we don't have to add or remove anything. We just pass on to something else. So this is how it goes. It's really a fun thing, really fun.
It's a project he hopes to share with his fans around the world this year.
There is buzz and there is expectation, huge expectation. I would love most of the people on Earth to know about these stories. And I would love that it actually contributes to their lives, that it impacts them, and that it makes them move forward.
To be taken by a photographer with this machine and all that, for them it's something, it's not usual.